Because in this video, we are going to see a modulo 10 counter. When I say modulo 10 counter, it counts from 0 to 9. And then again, it resets to 0. So, repeatedly, it counts from 0 to 9. When it reaches 9, again, it reaches 0. And then 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 9. So, let us see the problem statement. Write a program to count from 0 to 9 with 1 second delay. So, like how we have seen in the hexadecimal counter, here it is given. There we have seen 1 milliseconds. Here it is given as 1 second delay between each count. So, at the count of 9, the counter should reset itself to 0 and repeat the sequence continuously. So, for this, we are going to use the problem itself is given as use register path, HL, to set up the delay and display each count at one of the output ports. And the frequency is also given as 1 megahertz. In hexadecimal counter, we have seen it as 2 megahertz. Here it is given as 1 megahertz. So now we have to find out the count. Which count will lead you to 1 second time delay. So that is what we are going to see in this. So before that, we just go through the instruction which we are going to use in this program. LXA is for load immediate registered pair. So, X says it is a register pair, I say immediate. So, the data is present in the instruction itself. DCX is for decrementing the register pair and INX is for incrementing the register pair. So, now we'll write the program. First, we'll see the program MVIB. First, initially, we move for B register 00H. And then we are outputting this value because B in B only the data is from 0 to 9. So, B we are going to this B register, whatever is present in the B register only, we are going to output to the output port. Now, output port, then load the HL pair with the 16 bit, which will lead to 1 second delay. So, we time being, we don't know what is the count, but we are going to calculate it in short. So, generally, we write it as 16 bit, and in HL pair, the 16 bit data is stored. So, DCXH. So, when it say DCXH, both HL register will be decremented. First, L register will be decremented. When it becomes all the values in L become 0, then decrement of H takes place. So, each time you have to check whether the 16-bit register is value become 0 or not. So, for that, what we have to do? We have to move the L register value to accumulator. So, HL is, L is moved to, that is lower order bit is moved to accumulator, and then we do OR with the H value. Because H and L value has to be ORed. H value should be ORed with L, but we cannot do directly. So, first we are moving the L value, the value in the L to accumulator, and then we are ORing with H. So, this statement will do that. That is, it find the OR, it do the OR operation of H with A. Then jump on O0. If it is not, this will result in a, if it all are 0, then it comes out of the loop. Jump on O0 means when the values are still there in HL, then the 0 bit will not be set. In that case, it repeatedly do. Again, DCXH means, again, it will be decremented. Then a value in L is moved to A and then check for whether all the values are 0. If not 0, then it keeps looping. Then INRB. So when this is value 00 is output in the thing, this value 16 bit till that, this which reads to the 1 second delay, loop takes place. So for 1 second, we will see the output. That is the meaning of this. So for example, here 13. 12, 11. So, 1 second I am able to see. If it is not like that, then our output will be like this. If there is no time delay is given, see how it is moving fast. We will not be able to identify one output from other. See how fast it is moving. So, in order to avoid it only, we use the time delay where it takes like that. You can see the output like this. It will be visible. 51, 50 and so on. So, in order to do that only, we introduce the time delay. So, increment B. From 00 to it is now it is 01. Then move the value of B register this to A, because here also we have to check whether it has reached 0 or not. If it has reached 0, again it has to start counting from 1. So, here in order to do that, we are moving that to accumulator. the value in B register is moved to accumulator. So for example, here it is 00. Then we are incrementing. When it is incrementing, what it becomes? 01. So we are moving it to accumulator 01. Then we use compare immediately with the value 0A. So compare this value will result in three things. Whether it is equal to that value in the accumulator, that is the value is accumulator is equal to 0A. Here the data is present here, so it is equal to 10. Okay, is it equal to, or is it less than, or is it greater than? So if it is equal to, then 0 bit will be set. Or else, if it is greater than or less than, we have to check. So here jump on no zero display. If it is not equal to, when because now our aim is it has to equal to 0, because we have to calculate from 0 to 9. So if it is equal to, well, keep on incrementing, what happened? First 00, then here it is what is it now? 01. So it is not equal to 0A. It is 01. It is not equal to. So 0 bit is not set. When the 0 bit is set, when B is also becoming 0A. So in that case, 0A minus this compare, actually what it do is it subtract the value in the accumulator. That is why here we are moving into the accumulator, current B. So when it becomes accumulator becomes equal to this 0A, that is it actually subtract. When doing a subtraction, it will become a, when it becomes 0, when both the value A and this value are equal. So in which case it has reached the count. So at that case the 0 bit will be set. Till that the 0 bit will not be set, because now here it is after 00 it is 01. 01 is moved to accumulator, so it is check the value of 0A with the accumulator value, which is now 01. So it is less than, that is 0 bit is not set. So now what happened? Jump on to display here again. Now the value in the accumulator is output. Okay, so 01 is output. Then again the HL pair is set to the 16 bit value, that count, which will result in 1 second delay. Again, taking care of counting down. Then when it becomes 0, it comes out. Again, INRB. Now after 00, we have already incremented 01. Now it has become 02. 02 is moved to accumulator. So accumulator is having 02. Now it checks, compare, whether the value in accumulator is equal to 0A or not. Actually do subtraction. So since it is not equal, then again it goes there. And so on. So when it becomes 0A, say after 9, here it becomes 9. After some time, 8. After 8 becomes 9 definitely. So 9 is moved here, and 9 and 10. After 9 it becomes 10. 10 is nothing but 0A. After 9, 0, 9 it is A. So when it becomes A, what happened? Both are equal. So in that case, subtraction. When do the subtraction, it will result in 0. 0A minus 0 is 0 bit will be set. In that case, it comes out of the loop. And then jump on 0, start. It go here and start here. Again, B register is made as 00 and that value is output, and again it starts counting from 00 to 9, and this loop continues. This is the outer loop. Okay, so this is the loop responsible for introducing 1 second delay, and this loop will be, this is responsible, these codes are responsible for checking whether the B register has reached the value 9 and then 10. 10 will not be displayed. Instead, when it reaches the 10, automatically it goes here, the jumps to the starting position where the B is initialized to 00. So 0A will not be displayed. So it will display from 00 to 99 only. So now let us check the time delay calculation. Here, loop calculation, 24 T states. Why 24 T states? For this. See here, 24 is given. 10 plus this loop, 10 plus 4 plus 4 plus 6, so totally 24 T states inside the loop. So that into 1, because 1 is the one, the frequency is given. So 1 by 1, it is again 1 only. So we have 1 into 10 power minus 6 microseconds into count. Now we have to calculate the count only. So 1 wave, it's when the count is brought this 1 second by 24 into 10 power minus 6 will result in this, which is nothing but in hexadecimal. This is the value for 1 second delay, and which is given in hexadecimals A2C2. Now we have to keep this A2C2. We have to move this to the HL pair A2C2, which will result in the 1 second delay. Now, when you calculate the outer total time delay T0, here it is loop within the loop it is. Then outside the loop we have 45 T states. How see here? When you add this and this, 10, 20, then 30, 40, 45. So totally 45 T states outside the loop. Outside this inner loop. So here when you calculate 45 into, again this is the clock frequency, into, that is for one T state, this is a, that is 1 second time delay into 10 power minus 6. When you calculate this, you will have the exact count. Instead of this, see 41,666 is 41,665. If you calculate exactly, you will have this this value. So this is the this is the count which leads you to the 1 second time delay.